हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर दैट इज़ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स. ओके, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस दैट द सेल्स कैन डिवाइड एंडलेसली. ओके, तो टुडे अ न्यू स्लाइड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद दैट इज़ द टाइप ऑफ द सेल डिवीजन. तो बेसिकली वी कैन सी टू टाइप्स ऑफ अ सेल डिवीजन, दैट इज़ द माइटोसिस एंड द अदर वन इज कॉल्ड एज द मियोसिस. वॉट इज माइटोसिस? Mitosis is a cell division which lead to the growth and the developments. See, in the previous slide we have seen the four factors, okay, why the cells have to be produced. So there are the four part. Okay, first was the growth. Okay, the second was the replacement, third one was repair. So all these three was related to the mitosis. Okay, because they all lead to the growth and the development. Okay, if suppose there is a damage, okay, or if you get a cut and all, the mitosis is going to work. But the reproduction, okay, see, there are two types of reproduction in humans. Reproduction are of two type, asexual and sexual. We know that part. Asexual means only a single parent is involved, like in the case of an amoeba. Amoeba give a birth to a two new amoeba. So that is a mitosis, because they are the smaller organisms. But as we talk about the complex organisms like humans, okay, like plants, they undergo the sexual reproduction. This is called the meiosis. So basically you can understand like this: mitosis only work for the growth and development, whereas meiosis work for the reproduction part. Okay, the cells related to reproductive nature, reproduction. So first we are going to discuss about the mitosis part. So mitosis undergo two steps. The first one, that is the karyokinesis and the cytokinesis. So first we will understand what do you mean by the word karyokinesis. See, the word karyo means nucleus. Okay, you have heard about this word before also, karyo, that is eukaryotic. In eukaryotic also there was a word called karyotic. The word karyotic means the nucleus, and the word kinesis means to divide. Kinesis means what? Divide. So first step is karyokinesis. Karyokinesis means what? What to get divided? The nucleus has to be get divided. And the second phase is called the cytokinesis. The word cyto is related to the cytoplasm. Okay? And what we have to divide? Our cytoplasm part. So first we are going to discuss regarding the karyokinesis part. The karyokinesis part consists of the four subparts. That is PMAT. Remember like this, PMAT. PMAT. What do you mean by PMAT? P means pro, M means metaphase, A means anaphase, T means tel. So what do you mean by a prophase term? See, so basically, see what is going to happen. Suppose this is a cell. Inside a cell there is a nucleus. Okay, so in this, all this four stage, what is going to happen? See, in all this four stage, if you are going to notice, the nucleus will start to divide. Okay, the nucleus will start to divide like this. It will divide into two. So how this nucleus, this single nucleus, got converted into two? So in this lecture we are going to cover this part. So karyokinesis, the first part is prophase. The word prophase means first. The pro means first. This is the first phase. So what is going to happen? See, the more number of chromatids will get formed. Okay, the more numbers of chromatin will get formed, and if there is more number of chromatin, the chromosomes will become coiled up. Okay, there would be a perfect formation of the chromosomes like this. Okay, which has been divided by a centromere in the first phase. Okay, here they will try to duplicate many of the chromosomes. Okay, why they will try to duplicate many of the chromosomes? So that the cell division goes fast. Okay, cell division go fast and get easily complete up. We know a cell organelle named as the centrosome. Centrosome. What is the function of this centrosome? And this centrosome, just keep a note of this part. This is only present in the animal cells. This is only present in the animal cell, this centrosome part. So what exactly happens in this part? See, so this is a centrosome, okay, which is a cell organelle, which inside has a circle and a bar like this rod kind of a shape, which is called as the centriole. Centrally, and which has been guided by this has been protruded out like strikes and all, which are known as the esters. Okay, these are nothing but the esters. What is the function of the centrosome? The function of the centrosome is for the cell division. Okay, basically centrosome work for the cell division part. Just remember this part, in which, see, in the prophase, we know, we have studied in the first slide that there is a cell, okay? Inside a cell, there is a nucleus. Inside a nucleus, there is another nucleus which is called the nucleolus. So what happens in the prophase? This nucleolus, okay? And the nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane means this membrane. And the nucleolus start to disappear. This both starts to disappear, okay? And spindle fibers appear between the two centrioles. Okay, spindle fibers starts to get appear. What are the spindle fibers now? See, spindle fibers means like this. This is a cell. This is the centriole part. And the spindle fiber means like this. There is a formation like this, fibers. Okay, they started to get formed in the prophase. So what are the features of the prophase? Nuclear membrane and the nucleolus get divide, centrioles start to develop up the spindle fibers. Okay, the chromosomes numbers are duplicated and centrioles start to move apart from each other at the opposite pole. Then the second part, metaphase. What exactly happened at the metaphase? See, this was a cell. This was the centriole. See, right now I am not going to make ester. What do you mean by ester? This I am not going to make. You just understand that there are esters and all. I am just making it clear for you that what I am making and all. There is a formation of the spindle fiber like this. Spindle fibers. The word meta means middle. Okay. What does metaphase means? Middle. Middle phase. In this metaphase, the number of the chromosomes, each of the chromosomes are attached to the centromere. Okay. Each of the chromosomes are attached at the centromere. We know that part very well. So meta means middle. So basically what I mean to say, that all the chromosomes are present like this. okay, all of them are present at the center of the cell. So that is why they are called as the metaphase. Now, anaphase. Ana means back. Back. Okay. So we know that part. If you look at the chromosome, this part is called the centromere, which helps to attach the two chromatids. Okay. But the ana means back. The cell. Okay. The centriole. The spindle fibers. Okay. Here the chromosomes will get divided by the centromere, and each of them would take the half part of it, like this. This half of the chromatids, it is going to take the other half. It is going to take the other half of the chromatids, like this. Okay. So eventually, in the anaphase, a furrow starts to develop. A furrow means what? See, understand. A furrow starts to develop. Furrow means a gap like this. See, we can see this. There is a gap. A gap has been developed at the between. As the gap has been divided, it is called as the furrow, which is developed at the center. Why there is a gap which has been divided? Why there is a furrow being created? Because this is showing that if there is a furrow which is created in between, so it will help to divide it into a two nucleus. Like, see, ana. Ana means the end phase. End phase. What do you mean by end phase? See, now the chromatids were at the one pole, okay? This was the one pole, one of the centriole, and this was the other pole. So half of the chromatids were here, like this, and half of the chromatids were here. But in anaphase, there is a deep furrow. Ana means what? End. There is a deep furrow which has been created, in which the spindle fibers have been disappeared and a new nuclear membrane has been formed. Like, see. See, a two new nucleus has been formed. Chromatids have been formed. Chromatins. Okay, chromatin has been formed. The spindle fibers. Okay, this, what was the spindle fibers which have been formed like this? The line have been disappeared. We can't see a line right now. Okay, a deep furrow has been created. A new nucleus has been formed. Okay, a new nuclear membrane has been formed. So this is the four different phases. Now the cytokines. We have discussed regarding the karyokinesis, and this is the phases of the karyokinesis. See this part. This was the prophase. There is a one of the centriole. Okay. In the metaphase, we can see this spindle fibers. We can see this spindle fibers, which has been got form and all. And all the chromosomes are at the center, so that is why it is called as the middle phase, metaphase. In anaphase, the half of the chromatids have been taken by the one pole and the other half has been taken by the other pole. In telophase, there has been furrow which has been, we can see out here, and we can't see the spindle fibers because there is a development of a two new nucleus. Okay, two nuclear membrane has been developed. So this was the telophase. Now the second stage, cytokinesis. Cytokinesis means what? See, we have studied about this part up to the telophase. Like this. But when this furrow gets deep, it gets divided into two new cells. That is why this is called as the cytokinesis. See here, there was a nucleus, okay? And now are two different, one is this and this is the second. The two different cell has been formed. So this is called as the cytokinesis, okay? Which has been exactly divided into two parts. So this mitosis we can see in the plant cells also and animal cells also, because they both of them are eukaryotic. Eukaryotic means what? They can seen in the multicellular, okay, multicellular animals. Now there is a difference between a plant cell and animal cells. See, in animal cells centrosome is present, but in plant cells centrosome is not present. So that is why there is a formation of esters, but here the esters are not formed because they are lacking the cell organelle, that is the centrosome. Okay, here animal cells cytokinesis by furrowing of the cytoplasm, and plant cell is furrowing by the help of the cell plate formation. Cell plate formation means what? See, suppose this is a plant cell, okay, which is quite rectangular in nature, which we have studied. So here they don't create the furrow. In this they create the furrow like this. See this. They create the furrow. But in this they does not create the furrow. Instead of that, they form up a plate that is called the cell plate. Okay. It occurs throughout the body. It occurs only at the growing tips of the site. That is the shoot system and the root system. Okay, in the root system it can be seen and in the shoot system it can be seen. But this in animal cells, in each and every body part it can be seen easily. See this cleavage. See, I have already shown you, okay, there is a cleavage furrow. And in plant cells, there is a formation of a cell plate like this. Okay. Significance of mitosis. Mitosis, growth, repair, replacement. This three part we have discussed earlier also. They work in the asexual, like a small organisms. Okay. They work in the asexual reproduction. Like if the organisms are small, they are going to work in them. They maintain the same number of chromosomes. This point is very important. What does that mean? So we know that we have 46 number of chromosomes. Okay. Means a cell has the 46 chromosomes. Each cells divide into two cells. Okay. Two new cells. So this 46, the number 46, has been constant in both the cells. Like this is also 46 and this is also 46. Like understand, this is single, so this is 46. They are double, so that is why I have written as 46 46. So they maintain of the same number of chromosomes, so that is why they are also called as the diploid condition. Diploid word di means two and ploid means n, where n denotes the number of chromosomes. Okay, where n denotes the number of chromosomes. How many chromosomes we have? 46. In pairs, 23. Okay, so just substitute 23 in place of n. So if you are going to substitute 23 in place of n, so it would result into 46 number of chromosomes. Now, meiosis. See, chromosome numbers are half. This point is very important. See, and mixing up of the genes. So first we will understand okay, why the number of chromosomes have been half. See, understand like this. A single cell divides into two, this again divides into four. This is a condition of the meiosis. In mitosis, what is happening? A single cell is there. It only divides into two. Okay, it divides into two. In mitosis, they maintain 2N condition. That is the diploid. Okay, diploid condition they maintain. But in meiosis, they maintain up the haploid condition. What does haploid means? See. Suppose this is 46 chromosomes. When it is going to divide, so it will split into 23. When this is going to divide, so it will again 23. Okay. See, originally how many chromosomes does a body have? 46. But when it comes to a case of the meiosis, it gets reduced into half. So it gets split into 23 and 23. Then again, from these two cells, more two cells develop. So the number of cells are more. Okay, the number of the cells are more. Why the number of cells are more? Because meiosis work for the reproduction part of the body. Okay, meiosis work for the reproduction part. The number of cells are more, but the number of chromosomes have been decreased. Okay, in mitosis it was start also in the start also it was 46 and in the end also it was 46, but in meiosis condition the number 46 have been gradually decreased up to 23. Okay, it exactly became the half. And mixing up of genes, what does that mean? Let's understand. See, meiosis work for the reproduction in the higher organisms like humans, plants, animals, okay? Like multicellular animals, basically. So we know that part very well. We have maternal, we have mother and father. Your mother is called as the maternal and father is called parental. Okay, parental. Parenting. What is going to happen? See, in the start also I am mentioning that we don't get the all quality from our single parent. Like not all the qualities you will get from your mother and not all the qualities you will get from the father. You will get a combination of both of the parents. Okay, half of the qualities you will get as from your mother and half of the quality you will get from the father. Okay, so we know that part very well. So what is going to happen? See, there would be a mixing of the genes. Okay, there would be a mixing of the genes. Mixing of the genes consists of the two part. The half of the characters I am going to get from my mother and half of the characters I am going to get from my father. Here, if you understand the sequence, a human body has 46 chromosomes. Means a baby will have a 46 chromosomes. But this 46 chromosomes, he is not going to get from the mother only. Or nor do he is going to get from the father only. 23 is going to get from the mother. And 23 he is going to get from the father. So that is why meiosis is also called as the reductional division. Okay, because only half of the chromosomes it gets from a single parent and the other half he gets from the other parents. Okay, like the suppose half is gets from mother, so half he will get from the father. Now a crossing over condition. See, we have two chromosomes. See, suppose this is a father chromosomes. And this is the mother chromosome. So see, what is happening out here? There is a fusion between the father and the mother. So we can see a region out here. The father is represented by the red one and the mother is represented by the orange one. So there is a crossing over condition. See, a point. This is a point. This is called the crossing over condition. Chiasma. Okay, chiasma condition. Chiasma condition means what? Crossing over. Eventually, what is going to happen? See. This part be now orange, okay, because the parental characters have been exchanged with each other. Now see, now this part would be red. Now why there is then exchange of this colors? The reason is very simple. This is also called as the crossing over, means the parental characters are getting exchanged. So that is why a new kind of a features have been developed in the offspring, like a baby. We can see out here, see, crossing over. See the color exchange part, we can see here. See, this is the meiosis condition. We can see this is an interphase, first phase. This is a meiosis. Okay, the meiosis is starting from here. Meiosis is starting from this phase. Okay, suppose there are four, so it has been divided into 2, 2, and then eventually it remains 2, 2, 2. So in the start also I mentioned this part only. So there would be 46 divided into 23, then again 23, 23, 23, 23, 23. Mitosis, see, a single cell divides into two. In meiosis, a single cell divides into four daughter cells. Here eventually two were there, and in the end also there were two only. Okay, just an example to explain you the diploid condition. And here in the eventually it was four, and in the end it just got two only. Okay, so from four it got converted into two, so exactly half is called haploid condition. Okay, mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis occur in the somatic cells. Word somatic means the body cells. And the meiosis occurs in the reproductive cells. Reproductive cells means what? The testes in male and females, ova. Growth and replacements, whereas meiosis lead to a gamete formation. Gamete formation means what? The gametes means the sex cells. Okay, like the testes and the ova. Mitosis continues throughout the life. Meiosis only at the reproductive age only. What is the reproductive age? Around 13 to 14. Okay, the organs start to develop. In mitosis, two daughter cells are formed. In meiosis, four daughter cells are formed. In mitosis, there are diploid number of chromosomes. Diploid means what? 2n. Okay, it remains 46 only. Diploid means what? And haploid means single N. Instead, and substitute the value of N as 23. So you would get 46. And here only N is there, so it would be 23 only. Okay. They would have a single nuclear division. They would have a two nuclear division. Okay. They would have a two nuclear division. Like see, mitosis once, so only it will form two. See, mitosis one, so it will only form two. So only one division. But in meiosis, see, one will form two and two will form four. So this is the first division. and this is the second division. So two nuclear division we can see out here. So thank you students. So this was the chapter called Structure of Chromosome, Cell Cycle and Cell Division.